Well students, in this class you are going to learn another important topic in the lesson public administration, which is nothing but UPSC. Very very important concept, Union Public Service, Union Public Service Commission, Union Public Service Commission, which is nothing but we can call it as UPSC, Union Public Service Commission. So, first of all, what is the purpose to establish Union Public Service Commission by the government? And the constitution also will be dealing with this commission. What is the reason? First of all, a efficient public administration needed efficient staff. Is it correct or not? That we discussed in recruitment process. Efficient staff must be there for efficient administration. So here only capable citizens, only capable people can, what we can say that only capable people can take into civil service examinations. Civil service examinations. Can you give an example for civil service examinations? Best example, IAS. IAS. Only capable people can appear for civil services examination. And in the selection process of the civil services examination, there should not be political interference. Should not be political interference. Should not be political interference means any kind of political leader, political party should not involve in the recruitment process of civil services examination. And one more important, there should not be nepotism. I hope you are clear, children. Only capable and able students, they can appear for civil service examination, right? So, a right candidate will be selected for the civil service examination. And in this kind of recruitment, political parties and political leaders should not get interfere. They should not involve. There is no recommendations or nothing at all. And there should not be nepotism. Nepotism means what? Doing favor for one person. That is known as nepotism, or suppressing other people, that is also known as nepotism. So there should not be a nepotism, there should not be a political interference in the recruitment process of civil services examination. That is the reason why UPSC formed by the government. What is the full form of UPSC? Union Public Service Commission. So as per Article 315, very very important article. As per Article 315 in our constitution, there should be a separate commission for Central government and state. Very very important line, students, here. As per Article 315 in our constitution, there should be a separate commission for central government and state government. Sometimes two or three states, they can form as a joint service commission. So two or more states are having joint service commission. As per Article 315, there should be a separate commission for central government as well as state government. Sometimes two or three states, they can have a joint service commission. A joint service commission. Here, the central commission UPSC members and Joint Service Commission members are appointed by the President. Very very important. Members of UPSC are appointed by members of UPSC are appointed by President of India. The members of UPSC, Central Public Service Commission and Joint Service Commission are appointed by President. See, their tenure will be 6 years. Their tenure will be 6 years. Or else, they can continue until the age of 65 years. The members of UPSC are appointed by the President of India. Their tenure, office time, duration of office is 6 years, or else they can continue or they can retire before the age of 65 years. And more importantly, President having power to appoint the members as well as remove the members. Appointing members as well as removing members. Joint Service Commission or Central Public Service Commission means UPSC members are appointed by the President of India. Very very important. Here we are not talking about State Public Service Commission. We are talking about Central Public Service Commission, which is nothing but UPSC. And more importantly, UPSC Commission, it is not dependent on legislature and executive. It is completely independently working. It is completely independent from legislature as well as executive. So this complete description we are getting under the article number 315 of the Indian Constitution. Children, the question may ask why UPSC has been formed. You have to write. So there should be a capable people should be selected for civil services examination. There should not be a political interference and there should not be a nepotism. Due to this reason, UPSC has been formed. So it is all about article number 315. As per article number 315, there should be a separate commission for state, separate commission for central, or else two or more states, they can form a joint service commission. Very very important key point. Members of UPSC are appointed by the President of India for the tenure of 6 years, or they can continue until the age of 65 years. If they are not doing the functioning well, the President has the power to remove the members of UPSC. It is all about article number 315. Article number 315. After we discussed the structure of UPSC, let us talk about the major functions of UPSC. Functions. So, these functions of UPSC described under article 320. The functions of UPSC are described under article 320. The secretary of UPSC located at New Delhi. Secretary office located at New Delhi. Secretary means our day-to-day administration. It will be held from New Delhi. So what are the major functions of UPSC? For what purpose this commission has been formed? First of all, it will conduct UPSC. It will conduct examinations. It will conduct examinations for Group A and Group B post. Union Public Service Commission will be conduct examinations for Group A and Group B. It is the positions, Group A position and Group B positions. And after that, conduct interviews. UPSC will conduct interviews for direct recruitment. Direct recruitment. See, direct recruitment we discuss about within the department. Within the department, if the recruitment will be takes place, that is known as the direct recruitment without any giving notifications and all. For those kind of recruitment, it will be conduct interviews and it will advise government in case of promotions of the employees and we can say that transfer. If they want to promote any person to the collector, if they want to transfer collector from the one district to the another district, so those kind of things, the UPSC will be advise government. It will be give suggestion to the government and advise the government against disciplinary actions. If any of the employee is not doing his functioning well, so if you want to take any kind of action against that employee, this Union Public Service Commission will advise government to take any kind of indisciplinary actions against the employees. And more importantly, on the advice of President, it will give suggestion to the government. See here, five functions I wrote it here, very very important. You have to make it down these points in your notes. So first of all, the Union Public Service Commission will be conduct examination for Group A and Group B. It will conduct interviews for direct recruitment. It will advise the government in case of promotion as well as transfer. Promotion of the employee, transfer of the employee. Advise the government any kind of indisciplinary actions. Example, if an employee is not functioning well, then to take any kind of action against that employee, the UPSC will advise the government. And more importantly, on the advice of President, it will suggest the government, it will give suggestion to the government whenever it is needed. These are the major functions of UPSC. So now here, what kind of examinations the UPSC will conduct? Here I will write. Definitions or abbreviations are very very important. IAS, Indian Administrative, okay, what are the different types of examinations conducted by the UPSC? First one, IAS, Indian Administrative, Indian Administrative Service. Next, IPS, Indian Police Service, IFS, Indian Foreign Service, IRS, Indian Revenue Service, and IAAS, Indian Accounting, Indian Accounting and Auditing Service. So these are the important type of examinations conducted by the UPSC. IAS, Indian Administrative Services, IPS, Indian Police Service, IFS, Indian Foreign Service, IFS, Indian Foreign Service, IRS, Indian Revenue Service, and IAAS, Indian Accounting and Auditing Service. These are the different kind of examination. Students, these abbreviations are very, very important to remember. And what is the process of conducting examinations? UPSC will conduct examinations in three levels. How many levels? Three levels. UPSC will conduct examinations in three levels. First of all, prelims. Preliminary. First level of examination is preliminary exam. The second one will be main examinations, mains. Main examinations. And the third one is personality test. It is the last one. Personality test. It is nothing but interview, conducting interview. So UPSC will conduct examinations in how many levels? Three levels. First one is preliminary exams. It will short form we can call it as prelims. Second one, main examination. In short form we can call it as the mains. Civils mains they will say, UPSC mains. And finally, personality test. If the candidate will be cleared all these examinations, then he will be given training in the Indian Administrative Services. So that is so these are the three levels of examinations conducted by the Union Public Service Commission. First, candidate should clear prelims, and after that he should clear main examinations, and after that he should clear personality test, which is nothing but interview. If the candidate will be come across all these three levels, then he will be appointed as a civil servant, which is nothing but administrative. Is a part of Union means Indian Administrative Service. He will be appointed like one IAS officer. So this is all about the complete information regarding Union Public Service Commission. So my dear children, in this class we discussed the structure of UPSC, the functions of UPSC, and after that what are the examinations conducted by the UPSC. Finally, what are the levels of examinations and what is the process of examinations followed by the UPSC, which is nothing but prelims, mains, as well as personality test. So why UPSC has been formed? To appoint the right person without any political interference and nepotism. UPSC has been formed. Very, very important key point. The members of UPSC are appointed by the President of India. Article number 315 describes about structure of UPSC, and article number 320 that is discussed about the functions of UPSC. So in this class you learned about UPSC. In the coming class we will meet together to discuss Karnataka Public Service Commission. Okay children, thank you, have a nice day.